Hello and welcome to the Structural Guide platform. Today I will be solving the GATE 2018 question paper. Before moving to the first question from GATE 2018, I would like to discuss one question from GATE 2019 that has been missed in the previous lecture. Question is, the cause of short column effect during seismic occurrence is due to. The first, let's understand what is short column effect. Suppose this is a building rested on the sloped ground. And this is short column. During earthquake, suppose this is seismic wave. Seismic wave in horizontal direction. So during earthquake, all columns move horizontally, but short column attracts, this column, short column attracts much larger earthquake force. Why? Because this column, this short column, this is having high stiffness and strength as compared to the long column. So due to its high stiffness and strength, it attracts much larger earthquake force, and this is because of the high stiffness and strength. So there will be more damage in this column as compared to the long column. So this is because of the stress concentration in the short column. So the cause of the short column effect is the stress concentration in the short column. So the correct answer is the option number D, that is the stress concentration. So let's move to the first question from the GATE 2018. So this question is for 1 mark. The question is, the compressive strength of M25 concrete is. So what is the meaning of M? M is stand for mix, and this 25, this is the compressive strength of concrete after 28 days. So the strength of the M25 concrete is, the compressive strength is 25 newton per mm square. The strength is in newton per mm square. So the strength of M25 is 25 newton per mm square. Remember one more thing about this M25, the design mix. Suppose this is the M25, M20, M15 and M10. The design mix of the M25 concrete is 1:1:2, and for M20 it is equals to 1:1.5:3. For M15 it is 1:2:4, and for M10 it is 1:3:6. Do remember all these design mix proportion of the design mix. The proportion is of, this is of cement, sand and aggregate. So the correct answer is the option number B, that is 25 newton per square mm. So the next question is, collapse of World Trade Center that was in New York in 2001 was due to. So as you know, the World Trade Center at that time, the highest tower in the world, and it is made up of a structural steel. It was made up of a structural steel, and the structural steel is poor in thermal resistance. So the failure of the World Trade Center is due to poor performance, poor thermal performance of the structural steel. Moving to the next question, that is question number 3 from the structural subject. That is the structural grid type shown in the figure below is. So you can see here, this is not a type of irregular grid. So first let's understand what is a structural grid. Basically it is the reference line. It is a reference line in horizontal direction, in horizontal and vertical direction. So the structural grid is the reference line in horizontal and vertical direction, depicting the structural component in the building, and it is depicting the structural component in the building. A structural component means that is the load bearing element. So a structural component means that is of column, beam or RCC walls. So this grid is not a type of irregular grid. So option number D is incorrect. This is not a rectangular grid because this grid is of a square grid. So incorrect. Square grid, because the sum portion of this grid is of rectangular size. So this is also incorrect. So the correct answer is the Tartan grid. So correct answer of this question is Tartan grid. Let's moving to the next question. This question is for 2 marks. Match the building material with the distinctive property in the group 2. So what is the property of cement? As I have discussed in the previous lecture, that the setting time is related to the cement. Setting time is related to the cement, and the initial setting time of ordinary Portland cement is 30 minutes. And the final setting time of ordinary Portland cement is 10 hours. So do remember, so cement is related to the setting time. So for P it is 5. So eliminate the two other option. So for steel is related to the tensile strength. The steel is related to the tensile strength. So the option number B is correct. So glass, you can see this glass is brittle material and wood is related to the chairing. So the next question from the structural subject is a question number 34. Match the following configuration characteristic in group 1 with their seismic consequences in the group 2. So first option for P, that is re-entrant corner, the correct answer is the stress concentration at the corner. Next option, the floating column. First understand what is floating column. So the column that is not directly above the column is the floating column. So this column is the floating column. This column is a floating column because this is supported by the beam, not by the column. So the floating column causes the discontinuity in the load path. How the load will transfer? Load will transfer like this. So there is discontinuity in the load transfer. Option for Q is 3. P for 2 and Q for 3. So the correct option is option number B. What is irregular story stiffness? Irregular story stiffness is related to soft story failure. It is related to the soft story failure. So what is soft story? Soft story is one in which the lateral stiffness इज लेस देन द 70% ऑफ द स्टोरी अबव और लेस देन 80% ऑफ द एवरेज लेटरल स्टिफनेस ऑफ द थ्री स्टोरी अबव. सो बेसिकली इफ द स्टिफनेस ऑफ सपोज दिस इज ग्राउंड लेवल, फर्स्ट फ्लोर, सेकेंड फ्लोर, थर्ड फ्लोर, फोर्थ फ्लोर, इफ द स्टिफनेस ऑफ ग्राउंड लेवल इज लेस देन द 70% ऑफ द स्टोरी अबव, मीन्स द लेस देन द 70% ऑफ द फर्स्ट स्टोरी और लेस देन द 80% ऑफ द टोटल स्टिफनेस ऑफ द थ्री स्टोरी अबव, देन इट इज कॉल्ड सॉफ्ट स्टोरी एंड दिस इज बिकॉज ऑफ द इरेगुलर स्टोरी स्टिफनेस. देर इज वन मोर टर्म रिलेटेड टू द इरेगुलर स्टोरी स्टिफनेस एंड दैट टर्म इज वीक स्टोरी. सो वॉट इज वीक स्टोरी? वीक स्टोरी इज वन इन विच द स्टोरी लेटरल स्टिफनेस इज लेस देन द 80% ऑफ दैट इन द स्टोरी अबव. इन केस ऑफ सॉफ्ट स्टोरी देर इज लेस देन 70% ऑफ द स्टिफनेस इन द स्टोरी अबव एंड इन वीक स्टोरी देर इज 80% ऑफ दैट इन द स्टोरी अबव. सो द गैप बिटवीन एडजेसेंट बिल्डिंग, द करेक्ट आंसर फॉर दिस इज बॉन्डिंग. सो लेट्स मूविंग टू द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, दैट इज क्वेश्चन नंबर 49 एंड दिस इज ऑफ 2 marks. The question is the negative bending moment at point A of the cantilever is. So let's solve this question. So step number one is the calculate external reaction. So as you know, the number of external reaction in the fixed support is 3. The one is vertical reaction, one is horizontal reaction, and one is the moment. So I am naming it VA, vertical reaction at A, horizontal reaction at A, HA, and the moment at A. So in this question, you have to find the negative bending moment, that is MA, because MA is in anticlockwise. Why MA is in anticlockwise? Because this load, external load, point load and UDL load is trying to rotate the beam in clockwise direction about the support A. So there will be counter moment at the support A to remain in equilibrium. So the first step is calculate external reaction. For this, you have to apply 3 basic equilibrium equation, that is summation fx equals to 0, summation fy equals to 0, and moment about A, the net moment about A is equals to 0. So this is the basic equilibrium equation. So apply summation fx equals to 0. So summation fx equals to 0, that means the total forces in the horizontal direction, this is x and this is y, x and y. So total forces in the horizontal direction is equals to 0. In this beam there is one horizontal force, that is HA. So the total force HA is equals to 0. So apply next equilibrium equation, that is summation fy equals to 0. So summation fy equals to 0 means the total force in the vertical direction is 0. So here the total force in the vertical direction, that is VA, I am taking VA in upward direction and taking upward direction as a positive. So VA is positive plus VA minus the 20 kilonewton downward point load minus the UDL, that is on the whole span and the span is 5 meter. So total UDL. So total load due to UDL is equals to 10 into 5, and that is equals to 0. So VA is equals to 20 plus 50, that is 70 kilonewton. So VA is equals to 70 kilonewton, HA equals to 0. Now apply third equation, that is MA is equals to 0. MA equals to 0. So by applying the MA equals to 0, you can say that the net moment about the net moment about the support E is equals to 0. So what is moment? Moment is the force into perpendicular distance. So at this point A, so the moment due to VA is equals to 0 because it is passing through the point A. So here MA, that is minus MA, I am taking anti-clockwise as a negative. So minus MA, and the moment due to the load, point load 20 kilonewton, is equals to 20 into perpendicular distance 5, and it is trying to rotate the beam in clockwise direction. So it is plus 20 into 5, and again UDL is trying to rotate beam in clockwise direction about the support A. So again it is plus 10 into 5 into 2.5, because the UDL is acting at this point. This is 2.5. This is equals to 0. So MA is equals to 100 plus 125, that is 225 kilonewton meter. So this is the answer. Let's moving to the next question, that is question number 53. This is also of 2 marks. The live load and dead load in the 3-story residential building transferred through a single column, and the load is given 12 ton and 18 ton respectively. If the soil bearing capacity is 10 ton per square meter and the factor of safety is 1.5, then the area of column footing is. So similar type of question has been asked in GATE 2020 that I have already discussed in the first lecture. So here you can see the total load. The total load coming on the column. Total load means the load, the dead load plus live load, that is 12 plus 18, that is 30 tons. And the factor of safety given, the factor load, you can calculate factor load, that is factor of safety multiply load. So it is equals to 1.5 into 30, that is 45 tons. So what is the area required for the footing? So area required is equals to factored load upon the safe bearing capacity or soil bearing capacity. Safe bearing capacity, and it is equals to 45 upon 10, that is equals to 4.5 meter square. Till now I have solved the previous year GATE question of 2020, 2019 and 2018. So as you can see, the one question, that is the question of the column footing, is asked in 2020 as well as in 2018. So it is very important to solve all the questions in the previous year. So by solving the GATE previous year question, you can easily get good marks in the गेट एग्जाम। इफ़ यू लाइक दिस वीडियो प्लीज़ सब्सक्राइब टू द स्ट्रक्चरल गाइड चैनल एंड शेयर विथ योर फ्रेंड्स। थैंक यू।